Hi, this is Mohit from Fagor Automation. This is part one in the tutorial to create, edit, simulate, and execute programs on your Fagor 8060, 8065, or 8070 control. In this part, we will be creating and editing a program.
The procedure of creating a program is exactly the same as on the 8060, 8065, or 8070. For all these three models, this procedure of creating, editing, or simulating is exactly the same. So when you're in front of the machine, you can see a designated key on the keyboard, and that is called edit. It says edit on the key on every keyboard. So either you can push that key, or you can select edit from the bottom menu. As you see edit on the bottom menu, you can press that key as well. So I will push edit on the keyboard to go to the edit mode. From edit mode, I want to create a new program. So as you see on the screen, from the bottom menu, you can press open program. So when you press the open program, it will open up the Explorer. So in Explorer, you can see it selected PRG folder. So it is within CNC 8070, users, PRG. Now this CNC 8070 can be Fagor CNC as well, depending on the model you have, whether it's 8060 or 65. It may be Fagor CNC or it may be CNC 8070. So to move my cursor from one side to the other side, we can either click on the mouse, if you have mouse connected to the machine, or you can press focus on the keyboard. So there is a key called focus. You can press that key and you will see your cursor moving from one side to the other side. So in order to select or to create a new program, I'm pressing focus so that my cursor is in front of the file at the bottom. See here, my cursor is in front of the file. Now I will give it a name. I can call it any random name. I'll call it demo edit program. So I press enter. So there is a blank screen here. Now we can start editing our program. So I'm going to create a very small program of moving my tool to a particular location and making a circle, like making the tool to follow a circular path. So to do that, I'm going to just write a couple of lines. I would say G90, that means absolute programming. G70 is inch programming. Now I will program my tool to go to a particular position. I can say G0, X 4.5, Y minus 2.5. So I'm assuming we have a block which is 5 inches by 4 inches, for example. So that means the length of the block along the x-axis is 5 inches and along the y-axis is 4 inches. And whenever we put the block in the y's, in most cases the top side of the y's is fixed. So that means we will prefer to have the top left corner as 0 instead of the bottom corner, because the top side of the Y is fixed. So every time you put a block in there, that Y will always stay. The Y0 will always stay. So I would, instead of making it 2.5, I will say Y minus 2, because I want to make a circular path starting at the middle of that block. So I will make a circular path of 1.5 inch radius. So I will say I position my X to 4 and Y to minus 2. After this, I will position my Z axis, let's say Z 0.25, like 0.25 inches above part 0. Enter. Now I will plunge into the piece by programming G01, Z minus 0.25. I'm just going into the part, at a feed rate of 10 inches a minute. Enter. Now we will program a circular path. Just by programming G3i negative 1.5. This is a command that will, wherever the tool is, it will just follow the circular path and come back to the same point at a feed rate of, let's say, 20 inches a minute. Enter. So after the circle is made, we will move the tool out. I will just say G01 Z0.25 at a feed rate of 50. So after the tool is out, we can end the program by programming M30. Now, since we have not added the tool, I would like to go on the top of the program and make some changes. So I would like to add the tool number I want to use. So I bring my cursor in line number 2, I press enter, move up, and I can program the tool. So it is T02M6. So after this, it might be a good idea to program a spindle speed. I would say enter, spindle speed of S1000, M3. So after this is done, I would also like to add M5 before the end of the program. That would be to stop the spindle. So I move down, press enter, M5. So now since the program is made, we would like to test the program by simulating it.
Check out part 2, where we will simulate this program. Thank you.